My name is Greg Shyba. I'm the CEO of the Ann and Sandy Cross Conservation Area, and I'm here to talk about our concern with respect to the planned lighting on the new leg of the Ring Road, Calgary West Ring Road as it's called. Here at the Ann and Sandy Cross Conservation Area, we take real pride in using best management practices and to protect this area for wildlife in particular. When Ann and Sandy donated the land over 30 years ago, there was some anticipation that the city would move in closer to the conservation area, but we didn't expect to see the type of lighting that is now planned by Alberta Transportation. Frankly, we're shocked and very disappointed that here in Alberta, where we're trying to use best management practices or the cross, that the government of Alberta isn't planning on doing the same. They're relying on antiquated lighting standards, whereas the rest of the world, Europe, many places in the United States, are now using lighting that is much more friendly to human health and wildlife as well. For example, the wildlife here at the cross, we have cougars, bears, elk, moose, a lot of deer as well. And we know from looking at the scientific literature that lighting is a big factor in the behavior of wildlife. Predation, their eating habits, the ability of a cougar, for example, to take down a deer is much easier when the sky is bright. And of course, there's changes in the moon and some nights are darker than others. But when we have street lights just a mile from here that will in effect make this daylight almost all the time, it changes the behavior of not only cougars and elk and deer, but birds as well. We do know that the lighting changes from high lights like city lights or in urban areas change the behavior of birds. There's a lot of literature now, scientific literature, indicating that birds observe the night sky, particularly when they're young, before they fledge out of the nest. And it's by observing the night sky that they can find their way back to their natal home on their migration pattern. So they'll head down south in the wintertime, come back here in the spring, and with no night sky to observe and the stars, they can't find their way back to their natal area. Another huge problem from the literature is that the behavior of insects changes with lighting. They may gravitate towards the light. A lot of the insects that are here at the cross might go that mile down to the highway to by the light attraction, and that attracts the bats. The bats will go down there. The birds that might feed on those insects as well. So it's a changer. It can actually take wildlife away from the conservation area. That's a huge concern to us. We know that lighting is available, lighting made here in Alberta, that is much more friendly to human health and wildlife health. And we're urging the government of Alberta, particularly Alberta Transportation, to do the right thing. Let's show that Alberta can do the right thing when it comes to making decisions with respect to protection of values of human health and lighting and wildlife as well.